Okay, so now that we're coming very close to the end of our time, our work time, we need to dive into clustering these and getting the SLOs into the correct units. So Sherry, I know that you're going to be recording and getting information into the Google Doc, and we will follow along and make sure that what's placed into those into the chart is correct. But let's start by looking at back at 7.1 and looking at the SLOs there and start to determine where we should put the information from cluster 7, I'm sorry, from SLO 7.1. So recall at least three important details from the text. So which
that'll probably best fit in unit 1.
Which is a narrative unit. I agree with that.
I think it's also important to remember that some of these SLOs will fit into more than one unit.
Right.
And I think that...
I'm sorry. And we're not including everything. We're only including the SLOs that are being explicitly taught and assessed.
Right.
Because we don't need to include everything into for the standards.
Agreed. But I think we need to make sure that the SLOs where we know that our students have the most difficulty, we should make sure that they are found in several of our units, just to make sure that they can get enough exposure and master those by the end of the year.
Absolutely.
Great.
Sounds good.
So we're learning to recall at least three important details from the text.
So that could go into one, and I would suppose it would also go into unit 2 and 4 at the least.
I agree.
Working with informational and argumentative pieces.
I agree. Informational gives them a little bit of trouble, so I think putting that in there as well and getting them to identify those important pieces of detail from the text is a great way to practice.
Now, I'll say that again. Which units?
That's unit 1, 2, and 4.
Okay.
So for SLO 2, find one piece of textual evidence to support analysis of content.
Would that go with argument in unit 4?
I like that.
Unit 4?
Is there, yes, unit 4 is argument. So we'll put SLO 2 there in unit 4. Find one piece of textual evidence to support analysis of content. Do you think that there is any other unit where that should be taught or where it would be effective?
I think in unit 3.
Unit 3. Expository, explanatory.
Okay, so I'll move that. Oh, well, keep that in 4 and 3.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And what's next? What was the next one?
Analyze events from the text with 3 details.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I suppose that would go right back into 1, 2, and 4. I don't think it necessarily applies to unit 3.
I agree. It's a great fit for 1, and I think for 2 as well.
Okay, I put it for 1, 2, and 4. Are you able to see, Tony, the edits that are being made to the document, or
yes,
anyone who has it up?
I can see all the edits you're making on the document.
Okay.
Yep. Now, was there another one?
I think that's all we came up with for RI 7.1, correct?
Okay. Great.
Okay. So I think that this is really a great way to tie all of our important SLOs and whatnot together and creates really a nice visual to see, keep everyone on track, and it's great that we could collaborate and do this together. It's been really helpful.
And it's a live document, so we can constantly go in and make modifications as needed, and we'll be able to see the changes shared real time.
Absolutely, because if a month from now we decide that this SLO number 3 doesn't belong really in unit 2, then we could always adjust it and make modifications and
based on what we experience in the classroom. Definitely. I've gotten I feel better about understanding the information at each of these standards because, you know, once you have a chance to hash it out and look at it in great detail and talk about it, everything seems to be a lot more clear.
Right, yes, and it's absolutely definitely beneficial to hear other people's input because you may think that something is really great and then you realize that in listening to someone else, there is something that you've overlooked or not seen. So it's really been pretty awesome working together doing this.
Absolutely. Great job, guys.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Great job.